Everybody, Count Snagus back at you again today. Did you know when Mego first came back out, somewhere in those first three waves that were only available at Target, there was rumor, not really rumor, but it was on a list that they were going to do a double pack of Blade Runner figures. Now, it didn't happen. A lot of us know, but some of you don't know the reason why it didn't happen. It looks like they're planning on doing figures from the first 1982 Blade Runner movie. If you don't know, there are no figures from that movie. There never were really any toys except for an Ertl car that did have a spinner. I think it was Ertl who made that, I believe, if I remember correctly. But they were planning on doing it. It didn't happen, again, because there just aren't any toys. It looks like whoever has a license is not allowing it. But we do have evidence that Mego was going to do it. Why? Or how do we have evidence? Because of this figure right here, this Charlie's Angels figure.
This is the Charlie's Angels Sabrina Duncan figure that Mego had put out. And the cool thing is right down here is our evidence. That's right, that is the gun from the 1982 movie Blade Runner. Right there, it's got no paint on it. But we're gonna get that gun out of there, throw some paint on it, make it look like the original gun, at least paint-wise. But it is, I'll show you, we'll do a comparison. And we're gonna do ourselves a little kit bash custom Mego figure, Mego-like figure. But before we get going making this kit bash, why would you put this gun in with the Charlie's Angels figure? I have that on its side so you can see this a little better. Obviously guys, the gun was made, they needed to use it, so it's like, let's just put it in with this figure. This is Sabrina Duncan from Charlie's Angels. So there it is. So now let's crack it out of its box, its package. We'll do a little comparison with the original gun. All right, so I've removed the gun from the packaging and here it is. Sorry, the picture's a little grainy, but you get the idea. As you can see, it is the gun from Blade Runner that Rick Deckard used. And by the way, folks, the gun does not have a name. The Blade Runner movie never actually named what type of weapon it is. It's just a gun, very powerful gun that really is good at destroying, killing the replicants from the movie. Now here is the actual screen used hero gun that Harrison Ford did hold in his hand from the movie. There you go guys, there is your proof that Mego had planned on making Blade Runner figures that never came. But now, let's do some detailing to this gun and then we'll get going on actually that making the figure and also creating a card for it. And here are the paints I'll be using on the actual gun. On the left is a matte acrylic finish I'll be using as a primer and a finisher to seal up the gun. Then I've got a light tan I'll be using on the handle and of course a metallic paint and the red paint. The red paint's gonna be used very minorly. You'll see, it's extremely minor. I've completed painting the gun. Here it is in its original state as we got it from Mego. And I have to say now, after I painted it, I've discovered that the mold itself is very flawed, or just the way they come out of the mold, it looks awful. Now check this out when you see it with the paint. Here it is all painted. I did use a magnifying glass, a very fine paintbrush to get down in there. If you see it just with your naked eye without seeing this close, the gun looks fine, but this close up it doesn't look great. First of all, the paint, you know, it's so hard to get down there that minuscule, it's just not easy. And plus, again, the mold itself is not great either. You can see a lot of imperfections. Now here's the gun that we saw Harrison Ford with in Blade Runner, Rick Deckard. And now here's all three of them side by side, just for fun. All right now, so let's get into making our custom Rick Deckard figure from Blade Runner. Now let's get started with the head and the body. The head is called Handsome Henry. It's created by David Lee from Castaway Toys. Bought it from him some time ago. You might still be able to get it from him if you email him or send him a message through Facebook. He might just have some in stock. Also, the Type S body. That's what that body is called. It's the best Mego body on the planet. That also was created by David Lee, which is now available through Figures Toy Company's Classic TV Toys webpage. Link to that is down below if you want to get yourself one of those Type S bodies. There's no bands. There's no nothing inside, it's just ball joints. It's awesome, has great articulation. And to complete this figure, you gotta have some clothes, right? You need a long brown trench coat, a shirt and pants, also a tie, some shoes, and also a gun holster. Now I know some of you guys here are purists and you've already watched the movie, you know what he looks like. That shirt is not, it's not gonna work, nor is the tie, but it's good enough for now. The shirt he wore in the movie is actually blue and almost like burgundy at the top. Here's a shot of him from the movie, and as well as his tie. His tie is very 90s, I must say. It's gonna be hard to get that shirt
in that tie for this Mego figure. At some point, what I'm going to do is take this blue shirt that I have now, and I might actually dye it darker. Or maybe Figures Toy Company might have available on their Classic TV Toys webpage, maybe a burgundy shirt at some point, something that's a little bit closer. But for now, it's what we have, and it's going to work. You guys will see. Now here he is all put together, Mr. Rick Deckard. I think he looks fantastic. The trench coat, I did have to iron it a little bit to get the collar to stay down and keep it flat as well. So you might have to do that if you go this route, if you're gonna make this guy. As far as the shirt goes, in the middle of making this video, I did watch the movie, and you know, he changes his shirt, I think about 4 or 5 times in the movie, different times. And actually in the very beginning of the movie, he is wearing a dark blue shirt with a black tie. So eventually here I will take this shirt and get some blue Rit dye and darken it. So there you go. I don't need to get that crazy shirt that I was comparing to earlier. Let's go ahead and compare this figure to a shot of Harrison Ford as Mr. Rick Deckard. So you can see it worked that great. He looks great. You can do this, guys. Go on to Classic TV Toys and you can get all these clothes there and lots of other stuff that you can make your own little kit bash type figures at any time. But I think he turned out very, very cool. And how can we not do a close-up of this figure in this video? Here is the head sculpt that was done by Castaway Toys. Did you guys know that this head sculpt originally came from their Captain Action figure that was done back in the good old days, early 2000s? That head sculpt is the same as this. The only difference is that this one here that I'm using for Mr. Rick Deckard, they added a 5 o'clock shadow, as you can see to it, a beard. So move on down this figure. You can see how cool he is. Awesome. There is his awesome Blade Runner gun, taking out the replicants and trying to destroy Nexus 6. Just too cool. Too cool. I hope you guys can do this. Again, go on to Classic TV Toys, pick some parts out and put together your figure. Or hopefully you're really talented and you can make your own head sculpts and your own clothes. That's a really cool thing as well. All right, let's get going on the card for this figure. This is the card that I created for this figure. You can see the red border that goes around the sides of the card. I did that to make it look like one of the old 70s Mego cards from back in the good old day. I took a little bit of art from a movie poster from Blade Runner and added that onto there. And all you can also see below, it says Blade Runner. That's on the left side of the card. And just below it, there is a spinner there. And the background photo is also from the movie as well. Up the top, it does say Rick Deckard. We'll get a closer look on that card here in just a second. Now here is the figure on the card. The clamshell does come from Figures Toy Company or Classic TV Toys. You can buy it through Classic TV Toys, and I think it turned out fantastic. It looks great. As you can see on the top of the card there in Blade Runner font, it says Rick Deckard. Too cool. And again, there is the artwork that comes from a movie poster from back in the good old days. Blade Runner, there's your spinner. Down below, just for fun, I put a little logo I made, Count Stankus Customs. A lot of fun doing this, guys. I hope you guys can take some time and do this as well. It was too fun to do. I have to say, it depends upon skill levels. Obviously, the hardest part might have been doing that Rick Deckard's gun. I don't know. The card wasn't too hard for me. I'm not an expert at Photoshop, but you know, I've got a little bit of skill. I can do some stuff. But this was really cool to make, and I really hope you guys enjoyed seeing what could have been, what Mio could have done. But unfortunately, or anybody really, they can't do. But if you guys want to get Blade Runner figures, you can get Blade Runner figures from NECA. They did do 4 figures from the new movie, the recent movie that came out not that long ago. So there you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. So there you have it, guys. This classic kitbash custom Meagle-like figure from Blade Runner of Rick Deckard. You can put yours together today. Down below is a link to Classic TV Toys. Find your parts. Also, link down below to Castaway Toys and also Plastic Zombie Toys. Place where Jason Schirmer and David Lee reside together. Maybe they have a Handsome Henry head. Just gotta reach out to the guys and see if they might have it for you. Down below, leave some comments. Let me know what you guys think about Blade Runner or this figure. It'd be great. As always, guys, don't stop collecting and have a great day.